Despite decades of research and billions of dollars invested, our understanding of nucleosynthesis, the process by which elements are created, remains incomplete. The majority of elements in the universe are believed to form in stellar environments, with nuclear fusion driving the creation of elements up to iron and nickel. Yet, no experiments replicate the conditions inside of stars. Instead, most colliders are designed to simulate the high-energy environments of the Big Bang or supernovae, focusing on collisional fusion rather than the steady process that occurs in stars. These experiments have provided valuable insights into subatomic particles and the creation of some elements, but they fall short of mimicking the conditions where the bulk of nucleosynthesis is thought to occur. In stellar environments, extreme temperatures and densities enable nuclear fusion, but these conditions alone are not sufficient to overcome the Coulomb barrier for fusion. Quantum tunneling plays a critical role, allowing nuclei to fuse even when their kinetic energy is insufficient to overcome the repulsive forces. This delicate balance of forces enables stars to create elements, beginning with hydrogen burning to helium and progressing to heavier elements in advanced stages of stellar evolution. Without quantum tunneling, the temperatures required for fusion would be far beyond what stars can achieve, making nucleosynthesis as we understand it impossible. While this conventional model of nucleosynthesis dominates our understanding, alternative mechanisms could expand our perspective on how elements form. Low-energy nuclear reactions, for instance, have revealed intriguing anomalies, such as clustering of reaction products at specific atomic masses, suggesting nucleosynthesis pathways that might operate under far less extreme conditions. Although controversial and often dismissed, LENR experiments hint at fusion and fission-like processes occurring in environments vastly different from those traditionally associated with element formation. These unconventional reactions, facilitated by unique material conditions observed in LENR experiments, may represent new pathways for nucleosynthesis. They challenge the boundaries of our current understanding and raise questions about the environments in which elements can form and transform. By re-evaluating the findings of LENR research, we might uncover alternative routes for element creation, not just in stars, but across a wide range of settings, from interstellar space to planetary crusts. Could LENR provide the missing link in our understanding of nucleosynthesis, and offer a broader view of how elements are recycled across the cosmos? Join us as we explore whether these unconventional processes could unlock new insights into the origins of elements. Stars are nature's forges, creating elements through nuclear fusion in their cores. In stars like the Sun, this process begins with the fusion of hydrogen into helium via the proton-proton chain, which unfolds over billions of years. Larger stars utilize the CNO cycle, a faster but more complex pathway that also converts hydrogen to helium through intermediate reactions involving carbon, nitrogen, and oxygen isotopes. Beyond these, the synthesis of heavier elements occurs primarily through neutron capture. This slow process takes place over millions of years in stars nearing the end of their lives, while the rapid process happens in fleeting extreme environments or neutron star mergers. These processes collectively explain how stars contribute to the formation of elements across the periodic table, but they leave open the question about the full range of mechanisms at work in the universe. While stellar nucleosynthesis remains the dominant framework for understanding how elements form in stars, it is essential to acknowledge that much of our knowledge comes from the theoretical models and indirect evidence. Observations of stellar energy output, spectra, and element abundances provide strong support for these theories, but direct experimental evidence, particularly for fusion via quantum tunneling under stellar conditions, remains elusive. This reliance on inference leaves room to question whether alternative mechanisms could play a role, especially given the challenges of replicating these processes in terrestrial conditions. Unlike the slow, sustained fusion in stars, artificial fusion experiments attempt to replicate nucleosynthesis in two distinct ways. The first involves particle accelerators where nuclei are accelerated to high velocities, directly overcoming the Coulomb barrier and allowing fusion without the reliance on tunneling. These experiments are highly controlled but differ fundamentally from stellar conditions. The second method, exemplified by tokamak reactors, involves plasma confinement through electromagnetic fields. In tokamaks, hydrogen isotopes, like deuterium and tritium, are heated to create high-temperature plasma, where fusion reactions release energy. Magnetic fields confine the plasma, preventing contact with the reactor walls. Despite decades of effort, achieving sustained, stable fusion in tokamaks remains elusive. The contrast between artificial fusion environments and those within stars highlights a significant gap in our understanding. In stars, gravitational pressure maintains the high densities and temperatures necessary for fusion over billions of years, ensuring stability. In tokamaks, the lack of gravitational confinement and the reliance on magnetic fields create instabilities, which has so far prevented the realization of continuous fusion. This inability to replicate stable fusion suggests that our understanding of stellar nucleosynthesis may be incomplete. As particle accelerators became a critical tool for studying nuclear reactions, researchers observed that fusion rates were significantly higher than what classical physics predicted. The Coulomb barrier, the repulsive force between positively charged nuclei, required immense energies to overcome, but fusion was occurring at lower than expected energies. Quantum tunneling, first theorized in the late 1920s by George Gamow and others, provided an elegant explanation. Nuclei could probabilistically tunnel through the energy barrier rather than surmounting it. This concept was incorporated into calculations of fusion cross-sections, with a Gamow factor quantifying the likelihood of tunneling as a factor of energy. Accelerator experiments validated the theory by showing that fusion rates aligned closely with predictions that included tunneling effects. So, if quantum tunneling can explain why fusion occurs at a higher rate in tokamaks, could it also be an explanation for LENR? The standard tunneling model predicts reaction rates far below what is observed in LENR experiments. But LENR usually involves complex solid-state environments, where particle behavior differs from the free particle dynamics in tokamak accelerators. This makes it hard to directly apply traditional tunneling models. In tokamaks, the plasma environment is highly dynamic, with fluctuating densities, temperatures, and magnetic fields. These variations affect the distribution of particle velocities and, in turn, the tunneling probabilities. Electrons in plasma screen the Coulomb barrier, effectively reducing the energy needed for tunneling. However, accurately measuring the degree of screening is challenging, leading to uncertainties in fusion rate calculations. In some cases, observed fusion rates exceed theoretical predictions, suggesting that other processes beyond just quantum tunneling may be influencing the increased fusion rates. One common feature that both tokamaks and LENR experiments could share is screening effect. In LENR, the metal lattice may significantly reduce the Coulomb barrier, making nuclear reactions more likely at lower temperatures. In tokamaks, plasma screening may similarly affect the Coulomb barrier. In both cases, the screening could help overcome the barrier at low energies that would typically be expected for classical fusion. The key idea here is that both tokamaks and LENR experiments might be revealing limitations in our current understanding of nuclear reactions and the Coulomb barrier. The fact that reactions are occurring at lower energies than expected suggests that our models, based on the standard understanding of high-energy fusion and tunneling, might be missing key factors that influence nuclear interactions. So LENR might not simply be a laboratory curiosity, but rather could hold fundamental insights into the processes that allow atoms to fuse or fission. If LENR experiments are showing us that fusion can occur under lower temperatures and pressures than previously thought, it could suggest that we are misunderstanding some of the critical factors that influence nuclear reactions, and this misunderstanding might extend into high-energy environments like plasma pinches in fusion reactors or even stellar interiors. One of the problems is that the current fusion research, including in tokamaks, often rejects LENR-style effects as possibilities, largely because of preconceived notions about how fusion works in these environments. If researchers are focused on high temperature and high energy collisions as the primary source of fusion, they might not be looking for electron screening or other subtler effects that could make fusion more likely at lower energy levels. In other words, if the true mechanism for fusion are more nuanced than the high-temperature, high-energy collisions we typically model, fusion research could be missing critical phenomena that are actually happening in the plasma but are currently underestimated or overlooked. Both tokamaks and LENR experiments have drawn significant attention as potential pathways to sustainable energy. However, neither has yet achieved this goal. Tokamaks rely on plasma confinement through electromagnetic fields to replicate the conditions necessary for nuclear fusion, but they struggle with maintaining a stable energy-positive reaction. Similarly, LENR experiments, despite numerous intriguing observations of excessive heat and nuclear byproducts under conditions where classical fusion seems implausible, have yet to provide reproducible, scalable results that meet the rigorous standards of mainstream science. What LENR experiments do suggest, however, is that there may be a fundamental gap in our understanding of how nuclear reactions occur under specific conditions. The observations from LENR challenge conventional models and imply that nuclear processes might be influenced by factors beyond the established theories of quantum tunneling and high energy collisions. This potential oversight could have a broader implication not just for energy production, but also for how we understand the creation of elements both in stellar environments and on Earth. While it might be tempting to speculate that LENR mechanisms could play a role in powering the Sun or other stars, such claims remain highly speculative without a deeper grasp of the underlying physics. The conditions in LENR experiments are vastly different from those in stellar environments, and the mechanisms involved in LENR are not yet fully understood. Typical LENR reactions do not produce excess radiation, which is usually observed in these environments. However, dismissing LENR outright would be a mistake. Instead, the anomalies observed in LENR experiments should inspire a re-evaluation of nuclear processes and prompt further research into how these mechanisms might integrate with or challenge existing models. By seriously considering what LENR is showing us, we may uncover new pathways not only for practical energy generation, but also for understanding the broader principles of nuclear synthesis. This understanding could bridge gaps in our knowledge about how elements form and transform, potentially reshaping our approach to both scientific inquiry and technological innovation. While the path to sustained energy remains uncertain, exploring the implications of LENR could offer a way forward, providing insights that extend beyond energy production into the very fabric of our understanding of the universe. This potential re-evaluation of nuclear processes also opens up intriguing possibilities for element formation and transformation in environments beyond controlled laboratory settings. LENR's apparent ability to facilitate reactions under conditions that defy conventional expectations suggests that similar mechanisms might occur naturally, such as within the interstellar medium or under specific conditions on Earth. The interstellar medium, the vast expanse of gas, dust, and plasma between stars, has long been considered a reservoir for elements produced by stellar nucleosynthesis. However, the discovery of complex elements and isotopic ratios within the interstellar medium raises questions about whether stars are the sole contributors. In particular, nebulae and filamentary structures within galaxies might provide sustainable environments for LENR. These regions often feature localized electromagnetic fields, high energy particle interactions, and plasma dynamics, all of which could create the conditions necessary for LENR to occur. For example, filaments in the cosmic web which connect galaxies are known to carry currents of plasma and exhibit strong magnetic fields. These characteristics could enable the kind of nuclear transmutations that LENR theorists propose, allowing for both the creation and modification of elements in a distributed fashion across the universe. Nebulae, where stars are born, also present turbulent electromagnetic conditions and high-density molecular regions that could potentially facilitate LENR. These environments might contribute not only to element synthesis, but also the isotopic variations observed in meteoric and interstellar materials. If LENR occurs in these regions, it could help explain some of the observed mysteries of the interstellar medium, such as the unexpected abundance of certain elements, or the presence of anomalous isotopic ratios that do not fit traditional stellar nucleosynthesis models. Furthermore, LENR within the interstellar medium could allow for the continuous and localized element evolution, independent of the life cycle of stars, contributing to the chemical diversity of galaxies over time. The possibility that LENR might also occur under terrestrial conditions adds an intriguing dimension to the discussion. While Earth's core or mantle have traditionally been viewed as chemically stable or non-nuclear environments, there is increasing evidence that nuclear processes, such as low-energy transmutations, might take place under certain conditions. Hydrogen-loaded materials such as palladium and nickel have been shown in laboratory experiments to exhibit LENR-like effects, producing transmuted elements and isotopic shifts. If similar conditions exist within Earth's crust or mantle, LENR might contribute to element evolution on a planetary scale. Deep Earth conditions, including high pressures, temperatures, and the presence of hydrogen, might mimic some of the environments seen in LENR experiments. Such conditions could drive the natural transmutation of elements, leading to subtle isotopic shifts or the formation of new isotopes over geological timescales. This raises questions about the origins of certain rare isotopes and elements found in Earth's crusts, and the processes responsible for maintaining their abundances. For instance, anomalous helium and hydrogen concentrations near uranium deposits have traditionally been attributed to radiogenic processes, but they might hint at alternative mechanisms. Similarly, the discovery of uranium deposits at the ends of silver veins in certain mines presents another intriguing puzzle. While such occurrences are often explained by hydrothermal processes or secondary mineralization, these explanations may not fully account for the presence of uranium in these unexpected locations. LENR offers an alternative perspective, suggesting that low-energy nuclear reactions under specific geophysical conditions could contribute to the formation and redistribution of these elements. The prevailing model of nucleosynthesis assumes that all elements heavier than hydrogen were forged in the extreme environments of stars, either through fusion during their lifetimes or explosive events such as supernovae. However, the potential role of low-energy nuclear reactions challenges this paradigm, suggesting that nuclear processes might occur under less extreme conditions, broadening the possible locations and mechanisms for element formation. While stars have long been considered the furnaces of the universe, responsible for creating all elements heavier than hydrogen, LENR opens the door for a far more complex picture of element formation. It suggests that nucleosynthesis could occur in places traditionally deemed non-nuclear, such as the interstellar medium, nebula, or even right here on Earth. By considering LENR as a potential contributor, we might not only solve the long-standing mysteries about isotopic anomalies and element abundances, but also expand our understanding of the universe's creative processes. This new perspective invites further exploration and experimental validation to fully uncover the roles these quiet nuclear reactions play in shaping the cosmos. As always, be brave, be curious, the truth is waiting for us. Until next time.